getting real, guys. It's getting real. Things are happening that cannot be undone. This is what we've been waiting for. I'm teaching people how to go and see the truth for themselves. I'm a little emotional. Go to noahide.org. You have to teach the other people how to do this. Go to Noahide Dem0n Sublaws. No idolatry. Against entertaining the thought that there exists a deity except the name. That will no longer be allowed. You are being pushed into great error and travesty. You're about to be trapped up and murdered. Against turning to idolatry in word, in thought, in deed, or by any observance that may draw us to its worship. At first, it's going to be this idea that all paths lead to God. And then it's going to be amputated down to only Hashem. So that was the subheading of no idolatry. This is getting real, you guys. Go to blasphemy. And if you've already seen this, I apologize, but it's so important that people understand this straight from the horse's mouth. Look, to acknowledge the existence of just a generic plain God that was already named the name Hashem. To fear the name Hashem. To pray to the name Hashem. To sanctify God's name, even in the face of death where appropriate, the name. After desecrating God's name in the face of death when appropriate, I don't know how to pronounce that, the name. Hashem means the name. To study the Torah. Now, when they say Torah, they're talking about the Talmud. They have no respect, these unbelieving Chabadist death cult Jews. And they're all throughout Hollywood, and they're Masons too. I'm not even playing. To study the Torah, they mean the Talmud. To honor the scholars and to revere one's teacher. Revere. Just put worship in there, because they actually believe that they're gods and you as a Gentile are just some worthless piece of garbage animal. Against blasphemy. Blaspheming. Okay, so that's all your blasphemy heading. Did you see that? No idolatry, one. And number two, no blasphemy. Here is what is going to happen to you when you don't keep these. And how can they know your thoughts? Well, they've got technology. This is full bore insanity. Go to number 16. This is the courts of law that will be in every community. They already are. They've got the Mason headquarters everywhere, whatever those are called. Look, the court is to administer the death penalty by sword, decapitation, to testify in court. They can go on one witness to appoint judges and officers in each and every community. This is really important. That was under courts of justice. So you've gone here. Now, go over here. This woman is a Mason. I am convinced she is possessed by many, many devils, and they are actually talking out of her right now, although, you know, minus the pea soup and all that stuff from The Exorcist. They're teaching you and articulating doctrines. Listen to what she says. Now, keeping in mind that she put out this tweet, supposedly, before, and she lost all this money. I believe it was all a setup. She got her show taken away and all that. Okay, well, now she's going to talk about there's double standards. So watch. Look, zero tolerance. What she's not telling you is what I just told you, Noahide. But let's listen.
Well, what is racism if not a double standard? It's nothing but. It's a double standard. And so is anti-Semitism. It's the supreme double standard of this world, or at least the Western world.
She's saying that racism is a double standard, and then she's saying that anti-Semitism is the ultimate double standard. So she's kind of whining that she had made what was a racist comment or construed. This was all a setup, though, you have to understand. These are Masons playing the game. She had made a racist comment, supposedly, on Ambien about this woman as being from the planet of the apes. And it was that Iranian white woman that was Islamic. And everybody said that by her talking about the planet of the apes, she was being racist to Islamics. And she was saying, that's not even what I was talking about. I can't even remember what she said she was talking about. But anyhow, this is all coming to roost now. That was all make-believe garbage. Then they punished her, right, when she didn't go along with the narrative. You can't be racist. So this is now feeding into what she's telling you. Zero tolerance for double standards. She's setting you up to understand the Noahide laws without telling you the Noahide laws. And she's saying, your day's coming, Gentile, right? Because these Chabadist death cult Jews believe that they're gods. They believe that they're superior. They believe that they literally came and were birthed from their freakish Kabbalah, he, she, it, weird God, and Adam Kadmon. And their religion is just a real big mind. What is a nice word for that? I don't know. So anyhow, she's warning you that guess what? Yo, your day is coming. And they don't know about forgiveness. They don't practice it. They're not born again Christians. She's a Jewess that is telling the world what's coming. Satan has to tell you what's coming, but he gets to pick the person, the method, and that's what's happening here. And she's talking very quietly.
But you can't uphold a double standard for long without some kind of confrontation.
What she's saying is you can't uphold a double standard against the Jews for very long because there's a confrontation happening. And she put this out, what, a month ago? Okay, so August 22nd. So she, along with all these other Masons and Jews, all these people already know what's coming. That the international court is being moved over to Israel and that the UN right now is taking authority and they're going to give it to Israel. And now you're all going to be under Noahide. You're all going to be under Israeli law. So she's like, oh, you going to get yours. That's what she's saying. Or whatever is in her is saying it. And she's mean.
Ultimately, and I think that's what's happening right now. The standard that Israel is held to is going to be the exact standard that all nations will be held to. And that is called the dawn of the age of messianic consciousness.
Okay, I want you to pay attention to her body language. If you did not just get the creepiest, creeped out, creepy, 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 creepington ever, yo, if you have got spiritual discernment, if your spirit, which Paul called spirit man, if you have got your spirit man alive in you because you got reborn in the Lord Jesus Christ through the death, burial, and resurrection of the Messiah, Jesus, then you will know and respond. Your body, your spirit man inside your body will 100% have reacted to what this woman just said. I got the prickly things going on all over my body. Look at this. This is, oh, you gonna get yours. Do you understand what I'm saying? You see a human here talking, but I'm telling you, she's a conduit for demons and devils and things that go creepy creep in the night that are wicked entities. These are not nice entities. These are the entities, dear beloved friends, that when people play around and they open doors, they ought not to. These things come and they bother them in the night. Well, they go into temples that are open. She's an open temple because she doesn't have the Holy Spirit in her, right? We're going to back this up. She goes, she's talking so softly that it's really hard to hear and everybody complains that you need to speak up. The woman is a millionaireess, multimillionaireess, Jewess, wherever in Hollywood or wherever she is, and she can afford equipment to be able to speak at a level that everybody could hear. But this is part of the game. I'm going to tell you the truth, says the devil. And I'm not saying Jews are the devil. I'm telling you this woman is a Jew who has devils in her. And she's telling you that the messianic kingdom is coming. She's saying that she perceives that some standard has been employed against Israel of unkindness. And you know what? Join the club. What race hasn't been put down? What race hasn't been hurt? You know, it's the whole issue of the sin. We all contribute to it. But you just watch her body, man. You just watch. She says this messianic, this age of messianic, what'd she call that? Cosmic? Well, let's go back. It's really hard to hear her.
The dawn of the age of messianic consciousness.
She called it the dawn of the age of messianic consciousness. It's kind of like New Age and Kabbalah straight from the pit of hell. It's kind of got a little bit of Hindi in it, Hindu's religion. And she's already announced in other videos that the Moshiach is here. And so all these people know, all these Masons and Hollywood and stuff, government all over the place, they know that the world is now wired up with AI, which are really just spirits in the code, right? The quantum computers. Look at her eyes just looking at you like, oh, there's pain coming. And you have to realize that these people that are in unforgiveness and these entities, these spiritual entities that hate God and goodness, the idea of pain, it makes them happy inside. She says the same standard and measure that the nations have used against Israel is going to now be imposed upon you. And you have to remember that these Chabbadist death cult Jews, you have to remember, they believe they're superior and that all Gentiles are animals. And so I'm not so sure that she didn't have nasty thoughts in her mind toward Islamics. But then, you know what? You can't go the other way and go, well, the Islamics, you know, you have to understand that they also worship Allah. And so whether it's Hashem, the name, or whether it's Allah, they're all going to double cross each other in the end. But let's just listen again and watch this joy that just washes over her. Watch this, please.
Will be held to. And that is called the dawn of the age of messianic consciousness.
Come on, RoseAnne, you were forgetting the you missed it.
Confrontation, ultimately, and I think that's what's happening right now. The standard that Israel is held to is going to be the exact standard that all nations will be held to. And that is called the dawn of the age of messianic consciousness.
This is going to be the ultimate smackdown against all Gentiles. So this Rabbi Kessen and her are trying to warn people.
Well, the time is coming quickly, quicker than we know or understand or perceive. A time is coming when we will no longer be able to choose right from wrong. We won't be able to do that anymore, because what happens is when Mashiach is made known, when Mashiach makes its presence known, the whole world is going to. None of the old laws are going to apply, and